Welcome back, friends. In my earlier videos, in my previous videos, I have already discussed about the receptors, types of receptors, and the various drug receptor interactions, and I have also discussed one type of receptor, that is an ion gated receptor. So now I am going to discuss about the next type of receptor. This is a G protein coupled receptor and its structure and its functioning. So let us talk about the G protein coupled receptor. So G protein coupled receptor, it is nothing but a 7 membrane spanning. It is made up of the 7 membrane spannings of a hydrophobic amino acid. So it is a hydrophobic amino acid which is formed like a spannings into a cell membrane. These are the 7 spannings, which you can also call it as a helices. So we can say that G protein coupled receptor is made up of 7 helices. Okay, so these helices are situated like this. This forms a 3 loops, which 3 are extracellular loops and 3 are the intracellular loops. You can see here that. Now, as this is an amino acid, it has one amino end, which is NH2 end, and one carboxylic end or COOH end. So NH2 end is situated outside the cell membrane, that is the extracellular end, and carboxylic end is situated inside the cell membrane, that is the intracellular. So now we will discuss about its functioning. Before talking about functioning, we will talk about why it is called as a G protein coupled receptor. What is a G protein? G protein is a protein. It is a trimeric protein. It is a trimeric protein because it is composed of the 3 units, that are the alpha unit, beta unit, and a gamma unit. Alpha unit, beta unit, and a gamma unit, which is attached to a GDP unit. Hence, as it is attached to a GDP unit, it is called as a G protein coupled receptor. This whole assembly is known as G protein coupled receptors. Now we will discuss about its functioning. This is a binding side. Binding side is obviously, every time it is situated extracellular, when we are talking about the transmembrane receptors. So here is a binding side. Ligand will come. I have already talked about the concept of ligand in my previous video. So ligand will come and it will bind to the binding site, which is situated extracellularly. So it will bind to it, and as soon as the ligand will bind to its binding site situated on the extracellular end of a membrane, it will transmit a signaling. Signal will flow like this. It happens in the fraction of seconds. It will flow like this and it will reach to our protein, our G protein. So when it will reach to the protein, this GDP, which was attached to a alpha subunit, will get displaced by GTP. So as soon as this signaling will reach to our protein, this GDP attached to the alpha subunit will convert or will displace by GTP. No, this GDP is replaced by the GTP. As soon as this GDP is replaced by the GTP, this alpha unit, which was inactivated earlier, when it was attached to the GDP, it was in the inactive stage. As soon as the GDP has converted into the GTP, it becomes activated. And when it becomes activated, it detaches from its gamma and beta subunits. Now this will form like this. The alpha unit, which is attached to now GTP and to one beta and one gamma unit, this will remain attached to the cell membrane itself. Now this GTP and this alpha unit complex, this is in the active form, and these both are also in the active form. as these both forms are active, these are free to activate the other proteins. Now, we will discuss one of its mechanism. There are the various mechanism by which NG protein coupled receptor act. We will discuss one of them. Into the cell membrane, there is adenyl cyclase enzyme present. So, R alpha unit, which is attached to a GTP moiety, which is activated, it is in the active form and it is free to activate the other proteins or the enzymes. It will go to the adenyl cyclase and activate the adenyl cyclase. Now, this adenyl cyclase was inactive earlier. As soon as this complex will go and bind to the adenyl cyclase, it will become activated. Now, this activated adenyl cyclase will come into the cell, means it will come into the cytosol. It will come into the cytosol, and we know that there is the presence of ATP. There is presence of ATP. There is a huge amount of ATP present inside the cell. This adenyl cyclase, which is now activated, will come, this activated adenyl cyclase will come and it will convert ATP into cyclic AMP. It will convert ATP into cyclic AMP, and now this cyclic AMP will act as a secondary messenger. It is called as secondary messenger because we have seen here that primary messenger was our ligand. Ligand has given the primary action here. It has passed the message to activate the alpha unit. Now, this cyclic AMP or CAMP will act as a secondary messenger and it will further activate the other enzymes or other proteins. Such like, for an example, it will activate an kinase enzyme. As we know, kinase enzyme, this is a class of enzyme which is responsible for the phosphorylation and it will be helpful in the process of transcription. So, we have seen here that we will summarize it into the short. Our drug molecule or a ligand molecule will come and bind to the receptor binding site and it leads to the passage of signaling to the intracellular end which have here a protein, G protein, which is attached to an GDP and it is an inactive form. Alpha, beta and gamma, these are the three subunits and it was in the inactive form. As soon as this signaling will reach here, the three portions will be detached and this GDP will convert into GTP and it leads to the activation of alpha and detachment of these units. Now, gamma and beta will form a separate unit and this alpha GTP will be a separate unit. This will further activate the adenyl cyclase and adenyl cyclase will convert the ATP into cyclic AMP and cyclic AMP will act as a secondary messenger which will then activate the other enzymes or the proteins such as the kinase. Kinase is responsible for the phosphorylation and after the phosphorylation it will assist the process of transcription. So this was our second class of receptors and in my next video I am going to talk about the third class of receptors. So please stay connected. Thank you.